What's up, everybody? Welcome to the Foreign Fork Kitchen. My name's Alexandria, and this is the Foreign Fork, where we are cooking one meal from every country in the world. And today we're doing a little Austrian-German combo because we're making Wiener Schnitzel, which is popular in both countries. To start, you're gonna need 3 to 4 veal cutlets, and another term for that, if you are in the butcher shop, is also scallopini. So if you see scallopini or cutlets, both of those will work. The most important part of making Wiener Schnitzel is to know that you have to pound the meat with a meat tenderizer before you cook it. Pounding the meat is gonna ease up the muscles a little bit so that it's not so tough when you're cooking it, and it'll be a lot more tender when you eat it. So what exactly is Wiener Schnitzel, you might want to know? It's spelled Wiener, but it's pronounced Wiener Schnitzel. It's a thin piece of veal that is breaded and then fried, and it's normally served in Austria alongside some lemon garnishes and sometimes some lettuce or kale or something along those lines too. This recipe is pretty simple, so all we need to do is bread and fry. So first things first, I have 1 tablespoon of milk and 1 egg, and I'm gonna whisk them together to make an egg wash. You're gonna need 3 shallow bowls for this recipe because you're gonna dip the veal 3 different times. In your first shallow bowl, you're gonna have your egg and your 1 tablespoon of milk that's whisked together. In the second shallow bowl, we're gonna put 1/2 cup flour. And then in the third shallow bowl, we'll put 1 cup of plain, unseasoned breadcrumbs. Though sometimes I do mix cultures a little bit and put Italian seasoned breadcrumbs on them, and that tastes really good too. So with each cutlet, we're gonna follow 3 different steps. First, we're gonna dip it in the flour, then in the egg, and then finally in the breadcrumbs. Then I have a cutting board off to the side, and I'm gonna put each of the cutlets onto the cutting board while I prepare the rest. I have a medium-sized pan here, and I have enough vegetable oil to go up about half of the way on the cutlet, and I've heated it to about 350 degrees. If you don't have vegetable oil, you can also use sunflower oil or vice versa, they both work fine. We're gonna cook these for about 3 to 4 minutes on each side, just until it browns on the one side, then we'll flip it over and cook it until it browns on the other side. And now you know how to make Wiener Schnitzel from Austria and Germany. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you cooked alongside me and that you have a delicious plate of Wiener Schnitzel in front of you right now. If you need written instructions on how to make this recipe, you can find the link in the description of this video. And then you can also check out all of the other videos that we have on my YouTube channel, because there are some awesome dishes from all around the world with video instructions to go alongside them. Don't forget to put some culture in your kitchen this week, and I will see you next week. Bye, guys.